The history of the dance. We were watching you dance and we think it's so fascinating, the movement. It's like a dialogue. Tell us about it.
Well, telling you the truth, in terms of the dancing, that is something that I learned here with Los Paneros, because I met this beautiful old lady. She was my hero, I would say, my role model also too, Eugenia Ramos, mother of Taco, Timbalero, you know. And when I joined the group of Los Paneros de la Ventura, she was a dancer, as well as a singer also. And seeing her dancing, I learned a lot from them. And when I said from them also, I learned from Roberto Cepeda, because he also joined the group also at that time. So with both of them in the group, I was really, you know, learning on my own. And eventually when Eugenia suffered an accident, I became the dancer of the group. So although I knew a little bit, I started doing my dancing. And little by little, I would say I got up to this level that I would say I'm a good dancer of bomba now.
It's an honor for me to be able to, you know, to expose to many, many, many other people who didn't have a chance to, you know, to be here with us. But thanks God, with this type of projects, the ones that you're developing, they're gonna have the opportunity, you know, to see and to taste what we do, what we've been doing for many, many years.
About the history of La Plena.
Yeah, La Plena is an expression that was carried by migrant workers, and you know, there was a personality in the music already, in Puerto Rican music and the Puerto Rican people, and it was the combination of many influences. The African influence of bomba, which was happening for three centuries already, and then those people who came out to, you know, to work in the sugarcane fields and the other industries, along with migrant workers who came in to work in the sugarcane industry as well, they, you know, all those influences were, you know, got together, and that's how La Plena started about 100 years ago.
I don't know, when you heard that I was singing Campo, that's one of my favorite tunes, because it got you into that. It's like you're moving into something very spiritual, and your body start moving. And you start moving your body, and sometimes you don't realize what you're doing, but you're doing it. So that's why I say it's very spiritual too.
Si no bailo esta bomba me voy a morir.
African roots, the dress?
Definitely. Definitely. You see the turban? Most of the places that I go, how you learn how to fix your turban? That is something that I learned on my own. But if you see the African woman, they tend to wear a lot of turbans. So our roots come from Africa, definitely. The dance, the movement, everything comes from back home Africa.
Lo que es la plena, porque a mi casa se presentaba el compañero Emilio Escobar, que es muy amigo de mi padre, y siempre le llevaba unas parrandas navideñas a mi padre. Él era un gran plenero, yo no sabía quién era él. Simplemente, como amigo de mi padre, llevaba esas parrandas. A mí me gustó mucho. Cuando yo seguí creciendo, pues entonces ahí fue que yo dije, voy a bregar lo mismo. Y precisamente iba a la calle donde vivía él a llevarle la parranda, que nosotros en aquel tiempo le llamábamos la chambelona, ¿viste? Y en casa de Emilio Escobar, en la calle Fajardo, nos metíamos a cantarle a Emilio Escobar lo que él le hacía a mi padre. Bueno, se llamaba la chambelona porque había un compañero llamado Luis Salchicha, tú sabes estos apodos que hay de barrio, que era el cantante, y entonces cantaba una plena, en tiempo de plena, cantaba una música ahí que decía, panameña, 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 vida mía, yo quiero decir, ae, ae, ae la chambelona, y de ahí es que viene todo esto, ¿viste? De la chambelona, entonces todo el mundo conocía nada más que la parranda de la chambelona con toda la familia del barrio. Eso era a nivel de decirte a ti sobre 50 personas corriendo por todas las calles de Cangrejo, llevando esa música. De ahí nos salimos del barrio, aparecieron dos o tres carros, entonces nos llevaban fuera del barrio. Salíamos, para decirte la verdad, a eso de las 11 de la noche y no regresábamos hasta las 12 del día. Eso era parranda, que hasta los padres se ponían inquietos. ¿Dónde están esta gente? Y nos salían a buscar. Bueno, fíjate, comenzamos con esa cuestión de llevarla de casa a casa. Y teníamos una reunión que era en un sitio que le llamaban el Happy Corner. Eso era en la calle Castroviña, avenida Puerto Rico, en aquellos tiempos. Hoy se llama Castro Viña y Gilberto Monroy. Ahí se daba cita a todo el mundo. Bueno, a tal hora estamos para la parranda. ¡Vamos! Ya ahí se aparecía todo el mundo. Aquel tiempo no teníamos ni pandereta. Lo que había eran los timbales del primo mío. Y él los traía. Y eso lo usamos de pandereta. Y ahí era que arrancábamos. Con ese cantante que yo te digo, Luis Salchicha. Muy conocido. Muy bueno. Y con él era hasta el otro día uno seguir cantando. Y óyeme, había una energía tremenda. Porque imagínate tú. Estaban construyendo por ese tiempo la avenida Valdoriotti de Castro. Nosotros nos quedábamos ahí tocando, pero era cuestión de llegarle a la gente como nos dejó, con la luz del día, pero tocando. Que esta gente no se cansan, ¿qué es lo de esta gente? Pero eso, te lo digo que eso era así. Esa era la parranda de la Chambelona. Todo el mundo en esa área de Cangrejo, en esa área de decirte a ti, Calle Flores, Castro Viña, Avenida Puerto Rico, sabe lo que es la Chambelona.
Y el resto es la historia.
Eso es así.
Gracias, caballero, por estar con nosotros. Gracias. Le queremos desear esto, éxito en el futuro.
Muchas gracias y a ustedes por darme la oportunidad de expresarme como cangrejero que soy. Le voy a decir una cosa. Están mirando desde el cielo nuestros negros cangrejeros. Por ese suelo sufrieron. Muchos que lo defendieron y ellos miran desde el cielo a su suelo cangrejero, donde hoy muchos extranjeros predominan en su suelo. Estamos.
Gracias, caballero.
Hello everyone and welcome to Kids in the Classics at Van Cortlandt Park, and this is a music festival sponsored by the Bronx Borough President. My name is Lucia Ponte of Living and Learning by the Arts, and I've organized this event and I've got wonderful performers coming on. We're going to begin right away.
On a lily pad, there was a frog that went up did they see? A rabbit that went forward and forward and forward and forward.
Except to God, never felt I could call anywhere home. Tell a friend to sleep here in your arms. The sun never thought I'd fall in love. You're just my only saving grace. You caress my heart, kiss my face. You're just my only saving grace. Your love. Cause I feel so alone. Then I taste your kiss, your touch, your sweet love.
La obra ya está rodando, el tiempo está trabajando.
Okay, and we're here with a couple of lovely young dancers and their teacher. They just put on a wonderful show, and we hope that it's the first of many more. I'm going to let them introduce themselves. Your name is?
I'm Zelma Bustillo. I'm the artistic director of the School of Dance at Ballet Hispanico.
I'm Alison Marino, and I study at Ballet Hispanico.
I'm Natalie Ron.
I'm Mary Baird.
Carla Quintero.
It was a great show, ladies. I think everybody out here, if you could ask everyone, they'll tell you how much they enjoyed it. Do you girls plan to make a career of it?
Definitely.
I definitely do, yeah.
Yeah, I really like dance.
Hopefully.
Well, you do it very well. I imagine it's a pretty competitive field to be a star. Do you graduate a lot of girls?
Well, we don't graduate per se. They usually go through the development, you know, the intermediate, beginner, intermediate, advanced, and by that time they should be starting pre-professional work, which they're doing, and these performances are experience for them, which they need. It's part of their training.
So, tell me a little bit about your program. Is it community-based?
Well, we like to be a service to the community, but it's a nonprofit organization. Ballet Hispanico has three organizations within the base, the big organization. We have the school, we have the company, the Ballet Hispanico Professional Company. They tour all over the world, all over the United States. And then we have the Primeros Pasos, which is an outreach program in the public schools, a very big one and probably one of the best.
Mm-hmm. Is it limited to Hispanic children?
No, we have all. Mary's not Hispanic.
Irish.
No, Natalie's half Hispanic.
So you're Irish?
Yeah.
Yeah. How did you come to be in the program?
Actually, I've been here since I was three.
We're on 89th Street between Amsterdam and Columbus. So we have a mixed, you know, population there, which is very nice. It represents New York. We do have a lot of minorities and a lot of Hispanics, but we have people like Mary from the area, and you know, so it's not limited. No, of course not. Our doors are open to anybody that wants to dance.
That's great. And how often do you give performances?
Well, the company performs. They have a full year. But we perform. It depends. Sometimes we'll have two in a week, and then we might not have something for 2 or 3 weeks. And last week we had a performance where we had Ellis Island, the Medals of Honor. We've been at City Hall several times. We perform mainly in the area at events. You know, it's not... we don't get paid for doing the performances. It's an honorarium usually just to cover our expenses. But it's very good because there's a lot of exposure to, you know, we reach a lot of people.